kids, what do you know? It's Soundwave's Christmas. And you know what? It wouldn't be Soundwave's Christmas without a visit from our old pal, John Stanley.
That's
hey,
right.
John.
Hey, we just saw you on the Halloween show.
Hey, that was fun.
That was fun.
That was one of the best shows we have done.
Only because you were talking to Chasta and not us.
Oh, was
that's
that
what it?
Was,
was right?
that the reason? Oh.
Yeah, the restraining order is actually being processed right now, John.
It was a learning curve for me. Yeah,
right. How you doing, sir? This is your 22nd Christmas show?
Incredible.
We've had John on so many times here on Soundwave's Christmas, but the one thing I don't think we've ever talked about, we've talked about his career and horror movies and all that stuff. I want to know, John, what is your favorite holiday film?
Holiday film.
And I don't mean Silent Night, Deadly Night, or anything like that. Let's slide out of the horror stuff for a second.
Definitely. Then. Immediately think of It's a Wonderful Life. James Stewart, mm-hmm. Frank Capra film. You know, Frank Capra created his own studio. That was to be his first film, and he was going to expand out from there. And what a lot of people don't know about that film, it was a total disaster at the box office.
That's right, yeah.
Why? I will never quite understand that.
Right.
Here's another mistake Capra did. He forgot to renew it after the copyright ran out.
That's right.
So I think it was in the 60s mm-hmm. when it became
public
domain.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
suddenly it was on television.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And that's the turning point. Suddenly the whole world now was seeing this film like for the first time.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And suddenly everybody realized this was a lost classic.
Wow.
A film that had just been pushed aside after a few months.
Well, and when the stuff goes into public domain like that, then the next thing you know, it's ending up on, you know,
oh,
$2.99 VHS tapes and stuff like that.
It's on every channel. It's on, in those days, every VHS tape.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What is it about that film and the season that speaks to you?
Well, it's got that character from, he comes down from heaven.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And so it's got a unique kind of religious theme going for it. And the acting, Jimmy Stewart was just, I don't know, he was just really wonderful in that film. In fact, Jimmy Stewart told me a little story. He had just gotten back from the war. You know, he was a bomber pilot. And he went on more missions than a lot of men did. I think he did more than 40 missions in the B-25 eventually. Anyway, he had just gotten home. Life was starting over again. And Frank Capra called him up and says, I got to see you right away. I got a movie I want to tell you about.
Really?
So Capra comes to his house in Beverly Hills, and he starts acting out scene by scene. He's got a script with him, but he's acting out. And the first thing Jimmy Stewart thought was, a guy comes down from heaven? He couldn't believe that. He said, what kind of movie is that? But by the time Capra got through acting it out and explaining to him the inside way of looking at this movie, he was ready to do it.
Wow.
Yeah.
Nice. See, that's why I love talking to John. You ask him one question, you get Hollywood history. It's incredible.
That's great. we just wind him up and, okay, John, tell us all about John.
I'll be back. I'm going to grab a sandwich.
wait, stay here.
Nice.
He wants a slice of life, yeah.
So how old is your son now?
Son Russ is 53.
So you've had a lot of Christmases with him, obviously.
Yeah.
So back when he was just a little kid, you know, and back when you were a little kid, is there any traditions that you had when you were a kid that you kind of started to do with him when he was just a little guy?
Every Saturday, we'd go into town, San Francisco. We'd go to 23rd Street because that's where the first comic book store in America was.
Oh, nice.
All right. We'd go to the comic book store, and then we would go to one of the theaters, often downtown on Market Street, sometimes in other areas, to see a Saturday matinee.
Nice.
A couple of films or a new. I remember taking him to see a Clint Eastwood movie with Shirley MacLaine where she's a nun. Remember that one?
Yep.
What about you? Did you have any Christmas traditions with your
two
family?
Meals for Sister Sarah.
Yep,
that's
the one.
Yeah.
A lot of it was, you know, opening up one present on Christmas Eve kind of thing, just to kind of kick things off.
Right.
I was always the Christmas elf around the house. because
big stretch.
But my whole thing was that I would go through after they went to bed at night, and I would clean up everything. I'd go into the kitchen and I'd scrub counters and mop floors and all that sort of stuff.
Is this a deal you had with your parents that you were gonna like?
That I did. I just sort of adopted
that
as my thing. Nice. Unfortunately, my kids haven't fallen into that yet. But you know, and I would actually bake a little like apple crumble kind of thing, and I'd put a little sign with a toothpick that said "From the Christmas Elf." So then you get up in the morning, and that was like, you know,
nice.
Yeah. But my kids, yeah, not so much.
We did this thing around my house where we would go to mass at night, all of us, and my dad always seemed to forget something and go back in the house, right? I never put this together. This was like 4 or 5 years in a row, and until maybe I think I was 7 or 8. And it was the same thing every time. We would come home, and all of a sudden, my dad would go, "What's that sound?" And go tearing upstairs and run out the back. And he's like looking in the sky going, "Do you see that? Look right there. That looks like a sleigh." And we turn around, and all the presents are out. Like Santa came while we were at church.
Santa just left.
You know, yeah. So I think those traditions are great.
That was a great idea.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Wonderful.
So
wonderful.
Thank you, John.
Yep, absolutely. Yeah. It's always good to have you on the show. It just wouldn't be Christmas without you.
Thanks very much. And let's keep doing it, Dennis.
Let's keep
doing it.
Excellent. Pal. All right. Yeah. Big round of applause for John Stanley, everybody.
Thank you. Thanks, folks. Thank you.